Sprite. We're back from break, and joining me on the show now is Ms. Blondell Thomas, who is the Media Relations and Events Coordinator with the City of Douglas. Blondell, welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me, Georgia.
Hers is a familiar face that you have been seeing, as she has been seen like filling in for me these past couple of months, and I thank you for it.
Oh, yeah, I enjoy it.
All right, so I asked Blondell today to come, and we're going to talk about our annual Festival of Lights Christmas Parade. Mm-hmm. If you will, just tell everyone when it is that is coming up and what they need to do to get registered.
The annual Festival of Lights Christmas Parade is always the first Saturday in December, so this year it's December the 3rd at 6:30 p.m. We begin the parade at the Coffee County Courthouse, and then, once 6:30 hits, we pull everybody out and we begin that parade and get it over with.
Okay. How many entries do we typically see for our parade?
Typically, we've had anywhere from 70 to 80, but we have had as many as 120 to 130 before.
Okay. And some of our sponsors for the parade are?
The sponsors are Coffee County, the Coffee County Commission, the City of Douglas, and
the Chamber of Commerce.
The Chamber of Commerce,
that's
yes.
Right, that's right.
Sorry.
Hey, the two of us together, we're going to get it. And we do thank those agencies for sponsoring the parade, because people may not realize, but it takes money to put on the parade,
yes.
Which is why we have to charge an entry fee. We're sorry, community. Mm-hmm. If Blondell, if you will, tell everyone what those entry fees are.
It's $10 for non-commercial or individuals, and then $25 for commercial businesses.
Okay. And I know during parade, we judge on different categories, but mm-hmm. mainly for registration purposes, you're either going to fall into commercial or a nonprofit category.
Right, and nonprofit covers churches also.
Mm-hmm. So. That is correct. Mm-hmm. Well, let's talk about some of the rules this year. There's one rule that we changed and added mm-hmm. back to the parade brochure, which is?
Right, we hope everybody is happy now. We are going to allow horses back in the parade. Mm-hmm. The only thing with allowing the horses is that you must come in and register ahead of time. And we just ask that you have a responsible adult, and also that the horse is up to date with all its shots or vaccinations. Definitely make sure the horse has had its Coggins test,
yes.
which is it causes different diseases among horses, and just make sure that you come in and register. And it's $10 for individuals, or if it's a horse club, it would be $10 then, and they would just need to tell us about how many horses and riders they expect to have in the parade.
Right. And we do hope the horseback riders understand why we had to come to the conclusion that we did to take the horses out of the parade.
Mm-hmm.
We had a couple of issues, but it wasn't fair to penalize everyone. So
correct.
We hope with adding these rules that we have defined it a little more than what it was before.
Right.
And we want to remind all the riders, if you have not registered yet for the parade, mm-hmm. they need to go ahead and do so as soon as possible.
That's correct.
So that there will be no upsets the night of the parade. Because that is not our intention. We like having the horses in the parade. We just don't like some of the activities that occurred the past couple of years.
Right, and just out of safety precautions, if
yes.
your horse is a little skittish or does not like loud noises or crowd, then you definitely do not want to enter the parade.
Right. Well, let's cover some of the other main rules, and all of the people signing up for the parade, they really need to come into the public information office, pick up one of the brochures, or go online.
Right. You can go online.
cityofdouglas.com, mm-hmm. I think it's /parade. Is that correct?
Parade. That's
correct. And you can download the rules to sign, to just read those in advance. If wait to the night of parade, it's too much to take in, so really read those in advance. So we're going to hit some of the highlights.
Some of the highlights. We definitely want your vehicle or your float or your horses or whatever you're going to be doing in the parade. It must be lighted.
Mm-hmm.
You can go and purchase lights from Walmart. They have the inverters now, so getting lights on a vehicle is not as hard as what it used to be.
Yeah.
So we do require that all the entries have lighted.
It's a nighttime
yeah.
parade. We want it festive.
Have lights.
Yes.
Definitely lights. We do ask that there's no vulgar language, and just to go ahead and put it out there, if you are thinking of entering a dance team or something like that. You cannot have any type of provocative dancing this year.
That is true.
Unfortunately, we had some complaints last year, and some people even said not to even allow dance teams.
Right.
You know, that's the extremes that it can go to. So just make sure that if you are dancing, that it's proper etiquette, basically, to be in front of numerous different types of people. So,
and one other thing with that, Blondell, too, people need to keep in mind, the music that they play in their cars as they go by needs to be Christmas theme music as well.
That's right.
Because we have had incidents of some provocative and vulgar language coming across through some of the lyrics of the songs.
Right. So no profanity.
Yes. You will be snatched on the parade.
And nothing displaying like alcohol advertising
or
anything like that. Another thing that we try to remind everyone is there's only one Santa Claus, and that Santa is sometime during the parade. We don't really say exactly when he will arrive, but he is also he always comes on the big fire truck, on the ladder truck. So make sure that you know that we continue with that. Only one Santa, and also we do not allow candy throwing.
Yes, and I know people love to throw the candy and everything. I've got hit with it some up there at the announcement stand. Not sure if it was intentional from the public or not, but anyway, that's right, Blondell. No candy. That's another safety precaution.
It is, because sometimes, and you may not realize it, but when you throw that candy out there, that's enticement for children.
Yes.
And even
adults
though we
too.
Do, yeah. Adults too, you're right. We do ask that all the children are properly supervised during the event. Sometimes that does not happen. So out of safety for our kids and our adults, like you were saying, we do ask that there is no candy throwing. And then one other thing that we ask everyone to do is keep in mind, if you are driving a vehicle or either a motorcycle, that you do not do like burnouts, you know, squealing your tires and just trying to show out like that, because of course you can always lose control of that vehicle, and based on the number of people that we see in the streets, you definitely don't want anything like that to happen, and especially with you behind the wheel of that vehicle.
That is true.
We do ask that antique cars and the motorcycles are one of the first, are actually at the beginning of the parade, because we have found over the years that the stopping and starting that always happens, if there's a train that comes through or anything like that, it causes those vehicles to overheat.
That's true.
And I think there's something with the clutch system on
the
motorcycle that you have
and
to think about.
Like you said, if our parade have too many pauses, and it's kind of a long parade too.
It is.
Than some of the other area communities, so they they may burn out. So we put them at the beginning. You are right.
Right. And just, you know, we ask that everyone just come out and have a good time. And, you know, please bear with us, because we can't stop the trains from coming through. And sometimes the people on the other end of town don't realize that there's a train that's holding us up.
That
so
is
we do
true.
Try to keep it at a steady pace.
That is true. Well, like you said, there's a lot of parade rules to go over. And one of the other ones as a safety precaution that we just want to make sure we say today on the show is that if anyone have a generator on their float, you need to have a fire extinguisher as well on your entry or somewhere close by. So be sure that those two match up. But there's a few more rules, but some may pertain to you and your entry, some may not. But as we said, visit our website and download it, or when you come in to register, be sure that whoever's registering you also give you the rules as well. Blondell, who are our parade marshals this year?
We are excited about our parade marshals this year, and I think it's a good, it fits well with our theme. I did not tell that at the beginning, but our theme this year is Peace on Earth. So this year we chose to honor our local law enforcement agencies, and we've also extended that invitation to our county law enforcement agencies, Broxton Police Department, Nichols Police Department, and of course the Coffee County Sheriff's Department and the Georgia State Patrol. So we're looking forward to having all those guys and everybody to be able to show their appreciation for what they actually do for us.
Okay. Now, whenever the entries start lining up the day of the parade, what is lineup time and where do they start lining up?
Lineup is at 4 p.m. at First United Methodist Church, and we ask that all of the entries start lining up in the right-hand lane,
okay,
or the west, but mm-hmm. me, I'm directionally challenged, so right-hand's better for me. Right-hand lane is better. And then you just actually start from there. Just because you're first in line does not mean that you will be the first entry to come out. And just because whenever you come in and register, you get a parade decal. Just because you're number one, that does not mean that you will be number
That's
one
right.
in the parade route either.
Okay.
So we kind of leave that up to our officials that mm-hmm. kind of, you know, bring everybody in and make sure that we don't have too much of one thing all in the line.
Okay. Well, sounds like it's going to be a great year for the parade, and we just want everyone, if they have not registered already, enter. Even if it's not a float, because we know doing a float takes a lot of time and money, and you may not have all the volunteers in place, but at least put some type of entry in the parade to represent yourself and to help us keep this annual Festival of Lights parade going for our community.
Right.
Any other thoughts or things you want to share with us about the parade, Blondell, before we go?
Just one more quick thing. If there is bad weather, I mean, I have to say I am praying for rain. It may not come on Christmas parade day, but if we do have anything like that to happen, then the parade will be either postponed or canceled, mm-hmm. but the officials will make that executive decision.
That is true. And another thing we realize that we may be dealing with is that in the event our Coffee Trojans make it to the playoffs, which we want them to go all the way, go Trojans, go. But in the event, like I said, we will make a decision if we're going to reschedule the parade for that Sunday or the following week. Most likely it will be the Sunday the next day. Same thing with rain, because we realize people don't like moving their entries around too much. But
right.
The favor of weather have been on our side the past few years, and we have, there's been times when we've been, had this considered if the Trojans go to the playoffs, but they're doing so great this year, we just want to throw that out there so people would know. But just know, you don't have to flood our office with calls. We will post it on Facebook and get it out to the radio stations and put on our website, letting everyone know when it is rescheduled.
Right.
Yeah.
And we do have an event page for the Christmas parade, a City of Douglas event page, so people can go to that and I guess like that event and find out updates as they come in there too.
All right, Blondell. So anything else?
That's about it. I think we've covered almost everything.
All right. Well, we do thank the Chamber of Commerce, the Coffee County Commission, and the City of Douglas for hosting the parade. And we look forward to seeing everyone out within 2 weeks. Parade is coming up in about two weeks.
All right.
So we'll be back with some closing announcements right after this break. Before I leave, I just want to share some closing announcements with you all. Want to let everyone know that this weekend in Douglas, guess what? Santa is coming to town. Yes, he is. He is coming to the Martin Center on November the 26th. He'll be there from 12 until 3:30 p.m. This weekend is also the Shop Local weekend in our community, where we encourage people, as you're out in the community and shopping for the holiday season, remember to support the small businesses. So this Saturday and this weekend is Small Business Saturday, and in conjunction with that, as I said, the Martin Center is hosting Santa. And during that weekend, there are several participating businesses, so they're going to be offering some discounts downtown, Norris Shoe Store, Dolores' Florist, J&D Design, and also the Martin Center. So we just want you to be sure to support those small businesses. Our City of Douglas offices will be closed, and along with Transways, will be closed this Thursday and Friday for the Thanksgiving holiday. Now, the Thanksgiving, with us being closed, Transways scheduled for the Thanksgiving will be closed on Thursday and Friday. So the trash sanitation will be delayed for the Thanksgiving holidays, but we want to make sure that everyone have a great Thanksgiving. Want to remind everyone the City of Douglas is participating in the Georgia Municipals Association Mayor's Christmas Motorcade. That is a fundraising effort to support the patients of the Georgia State Mental Hospitals. If you would like to make a monetary donation to the City of Douglas to support our regional hospital, you can see Christy Morgan who is the executive assistant to the city manager at City Hall for that promotion. Coming up on Friday, December the 2nd, John Glosson will be in concert at the Martin Center as he presents A Night of Christmas. The general tickets are $15, VIP seating is $35, and you can get those tickets at the Coffee County Chamber of Commerce or at J&D Designs. That's coming up on December the 2nd at the Martin Center. Our Douglas Parks are